in today's episode of Art of Making. Rhubarb is an ancient instrument. History and technology of its production. Bildimchi is an unusual part of the national clothes of Kyrgyz women. History of a decoupage technique. This is how one of the ancient Uyghur musical instruments, rhubarb, sounds. These instruments can be of different sizes and can sound differently. The musician and craftsman Parhat Paltaev is holding a large rhubarb in his hands.
Rhubarb. Это очень древний инструмент. Уже 5 веков.
Rhubarb is an ancient instrument. 5 centuries ago it was invented by the great poet Kadir Khan. I have improved it since I have been making it.
Совершенствовал. Видите?
You see, the pegs are modern, so it will be more convenient for musicians to change strings and tune the instruments.
Менять струны, настраивать.
For more than 30 years, Parhat Paltaev has been working as a musician at the Uyghur Theater. The same amount of time, he has been making the musical instruments. He considers this work to be his main vocation and mission. A craftsman who makes musical instrument must be a musician, right? I need to know what the instrument will sound like. What will it look like? I pay a little attention to ornaments. Sound and timbre are the most important things to me. Parhat Paltaev's interest in how the musical instrument is arranged appeared when he was a child, when at the age of 5 he learned how to play on his first instrument. Sometimes I look at the disassembled instruments, I carefully study what kind of mistakes there are, which part is made better. You know, my father was a good carpenter. Maybe I got this talent from him. Desire and aspiration to make instruments attract me to this. When people bring me instruments for repair, first I look how it is made. I study it carefully, and then start repairing it. I think, so that is how it is made here. Every person learns from mistakes, right? Therefore, first you need to look at the instrument, its structure. When I make the instrument myself, I already have this knowledge. Here it is made like this, and there are a little bit differently. All instruments are standard. You look carefully at glued parts and joints and remember them. You see where it is assembled better, then this is how you should do it. Rhubarb is considered the most important and common Uyghur musical instrument. There are such varieties as bas rhubarb, dolan rhubarb, bes rhubarb, kashgar rhubarb, and Mili rhubarb. There are Mili rhubarb, a national rhubarb, and orchestra rhubarb. Now let's hear what it sounds like. More than 70 Uyghur national musical instruments have been preserved and are used to this day. Almost all of them are made of one type of wood, mulberry.
Она очень послушна, во-первых.
It's very easy to work with it. First of all, you don't even have to paint it. When you cut it, it's yellow, for example, and then it becomes darker. You just need to cover it with lac. Before painting, you need to fix the pecs. Farhad Baltaev is one of the few craftsmen who make Uyghur musical instruments. He not only invests his soul into this work, but also hopes that the work of his ancestors will survive and continue. That's why I decided to develop my national culture. I try to preserve my national identity. I try to teach it to my children. It's good when once the instrument is ready, it sounds well. You know, it's such a joy for me. I can't even express this feeling. Bildimchi is a below-the-knee swing skirt with a white belt. Kyrgyz women wear it over a dress. It is fastened with buttons or tied with a lace, which is usually woven from threads of red, green, blue, and white colors, with tassels at the end. Bildimchi wear two types, for everyday wear and for special occasions. Informal bildimchi were made from sheepskin without embroidery. They were worn by the wives of Kyrgyz shepherds, who roamed the pastures for most of the year. Such clothes were comfortable to wear and protected from the cold. Festive bildimchi were sewn from black velvet, embroidered with multicolored silk threads, and framed with a wide, beautiful border. The lower hem of festive bildimchi, as a rule, was decorated with otter fur. Such bildimchi were intended for dowry. As a rule, Kyrgyz women began to wear bildimchi after the birth of their first child. According to tradition, bride's mother brought it as a gift. A young woman received it from her mother a year after the wedding, when she came to see her parents for the first time after marriage. Tolgonay Bayra is the designer and founder of Bayra Fashion House. For 10 years now, she has been sewing ethnic clothes, both traditional and modern. Today she will tell us and show us how bildimchi is made.
Почему называется бильдемчи? Потому что он утягивает поясницу, крепко держит.
Why is it called бильдемчи? Because it tightens the waist, allows you to keep the posture, and it is also very warm.
Бильдемчи – это такая вещь, которая в первую очередь функциональная.
Therefore, бильдемчи is primarily a functional clothing item, not only for female beauty, but also for health.
В первую очередь для ее здоровья предназначена.
Today there are many different types of stylized бильдемчи. For example, for young girls, that is, you don't have to be married and have children to own one.
Бильдемчи такие, которых можно носить молодым девушкам, не обязательно тем, которые замужем или родили.
Kyrgyz grandmother sewed бильдемчи from dense cotton fabrics, but over time switched to lighter materials. To sew any clothes, you need a temple, a paper model of the future product. And first you need to lay out the samples on the fabric and make notes with a special chalk.
Мы сегодня используем ткань велюр. Это ворсовая ткань, то есть у неё есть своё направление.
We use velour today. It is a pile fabric, that is, the pile has a direction. And this must be taken into account. Бильдемчи is sewn from different types of fabrics, but historically, mostly dense cotton fabrics and velvet were used. They also had a cotton basis. But nowadays, velour is in great demand, because this fabric is noble, it looks like velvet, sometimes it looks even more festive, and at the same time, it's very durable. We got the patterns, and now we will lay them out. Previously, we haven't used patterns. Since the demand for Бельдемчи is high, we cut it right off the patterns, so as not to remember every time how we drew it and look for these formulas in our memory. First of all, when we deal with the belt, must be strong to tighten the waist. For this, several layers of fabric are taken, and then all of them are glued. After this, we proceed to the next step. We cut the fabric. Before the parts go to embroidery, patterns are applied to them.
Вот мы уже накроили наши детали, приготовили их на вышивку.
We've already cut out the details, prepared them for embroidery.
Прежде чем рисовать узоры, нужно выбрать.
Next, we add patterns, but before drawing them, we need to choose the style of Бельдемчи, because the meaning of the ornaments is different. The energy that Бельдемчи might carry will depend on what kind of ornaments you apply. We embroider ornaments with various kinds of threads.
На данный момент мы используем шелковые нити в основном, но бывают заказчики, которые просят из твердых армированных ниток.
Now we use silk threads, but there are customers who want the embroidery to be made of solid threads or wool.
Кто-то просит, чтобы нитки были с блеском, то есть.
In ancient times, natural threads were used. They were made of cotton or wool. All of them were painted, of course, with natural dyes.
Все эти нитки были окрашены натуральным, естественным методом окрашивания.
Previously, Kyrgyz women painted and embroidered patterns by hand. This process could take several months. With the advent of sewing machines, everything is much faster. And after all the embroidery is completed, the seamstress collects the details of the Бельдемчи and sews the skirt to the belt.
Мы вышли из вышивальной комнаты.
We just left the embroidery room, where we got our details embroidered. Now we will give them to the seamstress, and she will assemble our product.
Наши изделия.
We saw the whole process of sewing Бельдемчи. The finished product is ironed very well. After it, other manual work is performed. Buttons are sewn, and the Бельдемчи is decorated with various details.
Мы вышивали. И вырезали вот этот Бельдемчи.
This is how Бельдемчи we made looks like. We made it in a traditional style with laces.
Раньше бабушки наши вот именно вот так вот перевязывались.
Our grandmothers used to tie it up like this, and they wore it mostly like this.
Вообще мы шьем разные виды Бельдемчи.
In general, we sew different types of Бельдемчи. Of course, I won't be able to show you the whole process, since it's quite long. But I will demonstrate Бельдемчи with richer embroidery. We take patterns from different sources. Here, for example, Бельдемчи with ornaments from Тушкиюз, my grandmother's carpet. Look, when the product is made from one color, then all the embroidery, all the patterns look better.
Правда, конечно, снизу желательно, чтобы.
This is a traditional Бельдемчи, just like the one women used to wear in the past.
Более выигрышно смотреться. Вот. Это традиционные Бельдемчи, то есть те, как в старину почти носили.
Today we will meet the decoupage craftswoman Альбина Горкунова. She has been engaged in applied art for over 10 years. During this time, hundreds of beautiful products were created by her hands, and today her main direction is making handicrafts boxes and decoupage technique.
Шкатулка для рукоделия, там ты хранишь нитки.
This is a handicraft box. You keep threads and needles in it. Such boxes for jewelry and makeup products are in great demand. And on top of that, such boxes demonstrate the high skill of the master of decoupage technique. Because if it's a full-fledged box with a lid, then you not only realize your potential as an art person, here you must think over every small detail. It's not only about coming up with an idea of how the box will look like outside or from its sides, you need to think of its interior design too. And this is very difficult, believe me. Because sometimes you're puzzled over the interior part, how to design it in a way so it goes with how it looks outside. And this is such a difficult task. Of course, when someone praised you and liked your work, it's great. The result of the work brings you satisfaction. So, I'm interested in boxes. I love them. The history of decoration technique, decoupage, goes back to the Middle Ages. Decorating furniture with paper pictures began back in the 15th century in Germany. In this simple way, craftsmen came up with an alternative idea to create an expensive inlay of Oriental furniture. Therefore, these were mainly Japanese and Chinese motifs. Such decoration quickly became popular and was in a great demand.
Меня захватил декупаж. Я буквально все, что я видела, какие-то банки из-под.
I was thrilled with decoupage. At first, everything I saw, for example, coffee cans, cutting boards, in general, everything was covered with patterns made in decoupage technique. And then my professional career began. I found a website where decoupage craftsmen communicated. They were all passionate, like-minded people. New techniques were discussed there. They also shared links for the stores where you could buy blanks, jewelry boxes, key boxes, other interesting things, card cases. And I tried this technique, little by little. To be honest, I stopped using napkins because napkins don't give the result that you dream of. I began to look for printouts, pictures on the internet. I subscribed to the Pinterest app. And I just got captured by this wave too. There's so many beautiful things. Of course, I plunged into it all, so it started. I honed my skill and very gradually I started to create different works. People often say, how long are you going to do this? But this is part of me. Of course, sometimes I spend too much time working in decoupage technique, but I complete some work and take a break for a while, like all creative people do. One also needs to rest, to accumulate the next creative burst, so to speak. But I do not quit, no matter what. That's how I came to decoupage, I still do it, and I hope I will continue to do it. To practice decoupage, you need to have the following set of tools. These are five types of brushes, from small to a fan-shaped large one, priming and the so-called drawing. Decoupage glue is required, but a commonly known white glue is also suitable. You will also need primer material, special thin scissors, and decoupage cards and napkins, or paper pictures. And anyone can learn decoupage, says Albina.
Многие боятся, что вот я не умею рисовать и так далее. Любой абсолютно может. Для этого главное аккуратность.
Many people are afraid that they can't draw. Anyone can draw. For this, the main things you need to have are accuracy, perseverance, and patience. Because it's very important to withstand all decoupage stages, each of which requires patience.
Она требует своей выдержки, то есть там заготовку нужно правильно.
The workpiece must be properly prepared, properly loaded, and must be dried. After that, you must apply printout or decoupage card in the right way.
каждая стадия, если есть вот эта усидчивость, терпение.
Each stage requires perseverance, patience and accuracy. There is a lot of information. On Pinterest, there are workshops on YouTube posted by experienced girls. You can try it. Everyone can learn it. Just go for it.
Конечно, каждый может научиться. Handmade, он не любит, когда...
You don't need to rush while you're practicing some handmade activity. And if you want to get a high-quality thing, then, as always, like in any profession, being fast is not a good thing, right? Therefore, slow and steady wins the race.
Тихо, едешь, дальше будешь.
It was this motto that led Альбина to the world recognition. She won second prize at the decoupage competition for the creation of miniature boxes. And right now, she's going to show us how to make a decoupage toy.
Сегодня мы будем делать новогоднюю игрушку, потому что все декупажницы знают, что готовить сани нужно летом.
Today we will make a New Year's toy, because all decoupage artists know that it's better to do everything in advance. We have a lot of orders just before the New Year.
В том числе новогодних игрушек и порой не...
We're preparing a lot for this holiday. We make various products, including Christmas toys.
Вот такой пенопластовый медальончик.
Sometimes we do not have time, so we begin preparation in the summer. For the New Year's toy, I chose such a foam medallion today. But in order to work with it further, we need to prepare it first. What do we take for this?
Зачищать, шкурить, потому что здесь неровные краешки.
We use a professional sandpaper 240, and with its help, I begin to clean up the surface. Because there are uneven edges. Even though a styrofoam seems smooth, but it has flaws there, which we also clean up. This is something we should do. Now we have a perfectly sanded blank, but in order to continue to work with it, we should always prime it. Why should we prime it?
Почему мы должны прогрунтовать? Для того, чтобы...
First, we need to protect the foam from paint penetration, leaks, and so on. The primer, as if with a thin film, covers and aligns the surface. Then we will work further with this blank. After the workpiece is sanded and primed, the artist begins to stick the main drawing to it. For this toy, Альбина chose the motifs of Альфонс Муха. She cuts the picture with decoupage scissors and before wetting it in water, glues it to the workpiece with decoupage glue.
У нас одна сторона готова, но у нас же осталась и вторая.
One side is ready, but there is also the second side. It also needs to be decorated. Therefore, I went through many stencils, but I settled on such a drawing. It seemed to me that this is a very beautiful drawing, and it fits here. And now I will do it. And so we can put this New Year's toy on our Christmas tree, and it will make us happy.
Для меня какой-то...
Personally for me, it's some kind of a zen state, because I'm completely relaxed. I forget all about my problems. I get full satisfaction.
И удовлетворение...
My soul rejoices when I work, when I do something, and this work somehow goes smoothly without stumbling. It's a pure zen when I make something. This is how I can describe my state of mind. And when it's also in demand, or when my product is bought as a gift, or I see joy in the customer's eyes, then for me it's a double satisfaction. I don't know, I'm so lucky that I found my calling in decoupage. This is a real happiness for me.
экипаже, это настоящее для меня счастье.